And good day, sir!
Welcome everybody here to the final of finals. It is the fifth. It is the decider. It is what it all comes down to. 3.5 months, 4 months. I don't even know, man. It has been so damn long, this competition. It comes down to one game, one decision, one draft, and two teams. Luckily, there's two commentators here. Myself, Tubby One, has been with you through almost every single match of the defense. And luckily next to me is, well, definitely one of the nicest co-commentators in the world. He is sexy, he is smart, and he knows his shizzle. Let's jump in the game, and also welcome Sindh.
Thanks a lot. Yeah, this is going to be it. This is going to be the deciding game, regardless of outcome. This will be the final game. We just need to update the header a little bit, as it's saying 2-1 for Quantic.
It would indeed be a wise thing to do.
2-for-2 now, as Na'Vi took the last game out. And the teams have now been swapped, so the Quantic on the Dire side, Na'Vi on the Radiant. Quantic with the first pick as well as first ban here, and taking Na'Vi a lot of time to figure out what they want to do after
they
Quantic have banned Invoker as the first pick again.
Again this happens!
And they ban out Chen.
Please ban AM.
And Na'Vi now banning Darkseer.
If they ban AM, then Prophet gets through.
I think they're going to ban AM.
Yeah.
Shadow Shaman.
Okay, so they're baiting it. So they'll either get Prophet and Enchantress, or Prophet and Windrunner.
Or Prophet and AM.
And they're baiting the AM pick from Miguel. I'm wondering if Miguel's even going to worry about it.
I don't think he wants it.
We've seen many, many times throughout this final where Miguel just doesn't give two hoots and he goes to Prophet.
He's going to get the Nature's Prophet first.
I think it's almost a bait from Miguel. Testing him to pick the Anti-Mage. And Enchantress Windrunner. I love you, puppy. I love you for what you just did there. I also love Miguel for trying to force him to do it.
Yeah, he picked the two red-haired women. That's why you love him.
Hell yes. The long flowing locks of awesomeness.
And there's the AM for Quantic. No big surprise for me there. Mm-hmm. This is going to be it. And I've got to say, Na'Vi being Na'Vi here. At this point, what are you laughing at?
Oh, I get it.
Don't worry. Here we go. This is Quantic being Quantic. So we get ourselves an Enigma, they love playing that, and they love getting Link on that AM. He loves that farm, he gets the Battle Fury, and that's the way he plays. And Enigma and Prophet will buy him the time to play that kind of style. But Broodmother, quick pickup from Na'Vi, they want to deny the time. Enigma and Prophet will buy him a little bit of time, but only when they get the levels. And you got a Broodmother and Enchantress. This is a T1 tower down in the space of a very short amount of time. You got a Windrunner for a good side lane solo anyway. And if they grab one decent support hero for a push, tier one, tier two, gone in the space, under 10 minutes, quote me now.
Yeah, and this is a really smart draft by Na'Vi, I've got to say, to get the Broodmother at this point. I think they were kind of baiting it. They might have thought, all right, Quantic may have forgotten about this, or, well, you can't really get Prophet, AM, and Brood. It's probably going to leave you too weak early on.
Yeah.
So that means they've fished themselves a Brood. Quantic, however, do get the Enigma, which they love playing, especially on Angel.
I love how they ban the VS.
And they ban VS immediately. They don't want to have to deal with the swap. Like, well, yeah. That really prolonged the last game a lot, when
yeah,
you think
it did.
Of it. In retrospect, that was probably prolonged the game 10, if not 15 minutes, that Ryze was doing that well with the swaps on the Enigma. So Quantic not going to deal with that. Crystal Maiden is now going to be banned out by Na'Vi, which is very unusual, I might add. They always want to pick that themselves, but they're going to ban it. Nightstalker now thrown out by Miggle, so...
It's probably not a bad ban for them, because they have seen Quantic play before, and when you have heroes like Enigma as well as a Prophet, they want to have that mana without having the items to get that mana. And Anti-Mage is also one of those guys as well. Like, he wants to be able to blink freely. You always watch Link, and it's always funny to watch one hero in the lane just try and farm. And I don't know why I enjoy doing this, but I've watched Link just playing, just watch his replay, and him playing a game, and the second he can see a last hit, he will blink. He will spend the 60 mana if it gets him one extra last hit.
Yeah.
And that's the way. It doesn't matter if he finds himself out of position, he will get that last hit. Because for that, for him, that's a good trade, and CM lets him do that. But yep. Nightstalker now banned out, they don't want to give that to Horvost again. Venomance is banned out from Pumpy, they don't want Quantic stalling him up. They want to be able to push down these towers hard, fast, and not deal with harassment like Windrunner Lane.
And I also think this is really smart coming out of both sides. The Vengeful Spirit against Enigma was a good ban.
Yeah.
And then Poppy reads his opportunity here. Because with Vengeful out of the picture, him having the Enchantress with Chen banned, and then removing Crystal Maiden as well as Venno, he's effectively leaving AM with which supporter can they
which
get
doctor?
Again?
Which doctor?
Would they get that?
It's the only... Broodmother's going to screw everything up.
This is the problem for Quantic. It's really, really hard to be Quantic right now.
Hey, they can always get Storm Spirit.
I'm glad... I'm glad I'm not the one drafting right now, because this is a really troublesome situation to be in. He has to get a support for AM, but he can't get CM or Venno that he would probably want. The Venge they could have got, they've banned that themselves, and they're going to get Leshrac, who is good against holding off the Broodmother as well, but if he's played as a support, will not really get the levels to do so.
He needs the high levels on Lightning and Stun.
Yeah.
And then if they want to use him as a push, that's also an upside for them at least. But
I like the pick, but I think it's really hard for Quantic at this point to draft the right thing, because what is the right thing?
It's going to force Enigma inside the jungle. Enigma inside the jungle, and then I would even think they'd look at a Lich.
Run
the Lich AM solo mid. You can throw Prophet down the bottom lane. He can take care of that and give the farm to Leshrac on the top lane.
Lich could be a really good pick, which is very rarely picked, but in this situation, it could really be the one to go for, because Lich, together with AM in that mid, the reason Lich has kind of fallen out of favor.
Hang on.
Is that.
I just realized who's going to be in mid.
Who?
The final hero who we have not seen for this entire game, which everybody. Okay, that was not who I was freaking thinking, puppy. I was thinking Pudge. Pudge is the final pickup for Na'Vi right now. They still need themselves a solo mid hero.
Or Obsidian Destroyer.
Sand King's the last one from Miguel. Not a bad pickup. Gives him some team fight. I can't believe we forgot about him. But it's still forcing Leshrac as a support, and that's not what they want. But who does Puppy want as the last one? I really think we're going to see a Dendi Pudge. Unless he's not feeling confident with, because he has been spiking a little bit from his own internet connection tonight. That could cause some issues. Maybe. Come on, Puppy. Give me my juicy fat guy with a hawk.
It could be a pretty damn good pick here.
Yeah.
I'm not sure it's what they want.
I don't know if it's what they want either, but they're running out of time. Ricky Maru.
Oh.
They're going to go the damage. Avorce gets to play Ricky, and it's a nice counter to a lot of the heroes. AM can't blink. SK can't stay inside a Sandstorm. Leshrac. How does that work? Pop your ultimate off and you're getting caught inside a cloud?
Then it stops. Yeah.
Angel, can't pop the black hole. Ryze can't TP out.
Ryze playing Prophet.
Ryze is going to be playing as Nature's Prophet. Miguel playing as the Leshrac. Go figure. What? Angel is going to play Enigma. Mania is SK. That is obvious. And Link is heading towards the mid lane as the anti-mage. Down towards our bottom for Na'Vi. Dendi will take the Windrunner. Arsat takes Jakiro. Havorce takes Ricky Maru. Puppy for however many freaking times. Is it all five games, all four games tonight? He's been playing Enchantress?
No. He played Storm Spirit.
He played Storm Spirit.
I think he's only played Enchantress once before.
No. One Storm, three Enchantress. He's definitely played Enchantress multiple times. Unless that was taken by Quantic.
Quantic had it
actually,
one game.
Yeah, Quantic
Rise.
And that was when he
that
Storm
was
Spirit.
When he was Storm. I guess you're right, yeah.
And who else we got? Line of Heaven's going to be taking the Broodmother on the top lane. 30 seconds to battle. He does like to solo push with the Windrunner. But Line of Heaven not on a Windrunner.
No.
Go figure. Give it to Dendi.
Dendi solo mid Windrunner. He loves playing this.
He's already there. Him versus Ryze.
But this game
is
going to be crazy.
Ryze dropping wards.
And the thing about what Na'Vi are doing here by supporting up this Ricky Maru, they're like, okay, we're going to let AM have fun. Yep. They're going to do that. But they're going to give Ricky Maru equal, if not even better, farm for this mid game, and then they're gonna try to make it happen in the mid game. That's they have THD and Enchantress, and that just has to work out early on.
Yeah.
The thing about THD, which we rarely see, of course, we should be calling it Jakiro when it's Dota 2. It's the only name of the hero.
I've always called it Jakiro instead of Twin-Headed Dragon. But I don't know why.
Liquid Fire is one of the best skills for pushing in the whole game.
Oh man,
it's absolutely insane. The way it slows down the tower. If you look at it, try to take a look at what it does in level 4. Liquid Fire. 50% attack speed slow on towers. 25 burn damage per second. It deals more damage than Dragon Knight's ultimate on the tower and burns it. It's pretty insane. It's really, really powerful.
Mid lane, Ryze and Link, a Prophet as well as an anti-mage.
Very unusual.
Is our middle lane. And that's going to leave Miguel getting farm up on the top lane against Line of Heaven, combining with Mania. So they're splitting this. So it's going to be pull and attack. And that's why we're seeing the sentry wards up here. They want to keep Line of Heaven off it. And Line of Heaven had a horrible start too. He went for that top. I don't know if you're watching that. The ward was dropped down by Prophet. And Line of Heaven tried to go for the rune. And he was there for it, but the rune spawned on the opposite side. I'm hearing Prophet TP. Is he baiting this? I think he is. But Light of Heaven was denied a full half a minute on that top lane, giving space for SK to go. And now Dendi's got to be careful. Ryze is still baiting that TP on them. He's got no Sprout, and Dendi knows this, so he's not really fearing too much.
And even so, he still has a Tango left, but they're doing a good job at making him use his Tangos here in the mid lane. So if Dendi uses the last one now, he still has Power Shot.
Puppy
though.
Smoke as well as Arsat coming through the rear with double Ursa onto Angel. First clap, second clap, slow, stun, breath. Puppy gets the first blood. Na'Vi, take it. And the scream of first blood comes out.
And this is more than just a first blood, it's a big bite on the tower as well. They're going to immediately push this out with, and he's not skilling just yet. There's
look at Ricky.
Fire.
He wants to go again.
Oh, Angel.
Smoke goes up, and Angel just getting out of range of it, and splits the stun on Ricky Mara, but there's only a level 1 stun. Prophet's going to TP for this, and the blade frame breath goes out again. Angel getting a lot of damage. It might even be enough to kill him. Arsar's going to get the last right click. Two kills already for Na'Vi on the bottom lane. What a start to game 5.
Very offensive TP there from Angel. And Ryze!
Ryze is caught!
Oh.
His own creep wave is blocking him in! The creeps turn against him!
Whoa. That is... I'm trying to imagine a worse start for that bottom lane, but I can't.
There is none. Havoc is going to lap it up. He's going to get the levels. Puppy's going to get the farm. Already with the Ring of Basilius in 8400. And we're only under 3 minutes into the game. AM doesn't even have that much. And Arsat also got the last hit, so he buys up boots. His mana boost won't be too far off. Did Havoc even get a kill on that bottom lane? It all went to the supports, which, in my mind, is a crap load better.
It's really good for Na'Vi to get these kills early on Puppy and Arsat, because they're going to want to have this goal early on. They're letting Rikimaru get all the farm on the lane, so he's going to get filthy rich no matter what. They don't really need him to get the kills. But by getting them on Enchantress and THD, and Jakira, like you pointed out, they're going to get boots on both Puppy as well as Arsat. Puppy also flies out some regen, so he doesn't have to go back to base, making him his game a lot more effective at this point.
There is one thing which we haven't taken into account, and that is top lane.
Yeah,
Light of Heaven is 0 for 0. This is what happened to the Mirana of Link last time. Ryze going to TP towards the top lane, so they might just think, you know what, let's push this. This is our lane of advantage. SK is getting good farm. Miguel's also just sitting there. He's getting good levels, and they can push with 2 levels of Edict. This will be a tower, and this will counter off the amount of money they've just lost. Already 21 for 3 is what we've seen middle lane get. Danny's having a great time, but SK, who has managed to pick up 18 for 8, and you got Miguel at 3 for 0 with the levels, and now a tier 1 tower to go down.
Yeah, but they're using the glyph very well here. It's going to last for the entirety of Diabolic Edict almost, and the damage done to this tower. I'm not sure Quantic can finish this off if there's any help coming out of Na'Vi. Looks like there's not. They're going to let it go.
They should.
They're trying to get the trade on bottom. They're really close to that one. Arsat now, and this is a skill build I love to see. He's getting dual breath and liquid fire. No point in Ice Path.
Well, the stun is so hard to land anyway. The maneuverability of Quantic is too much. You're not going to be able to land it properly. So, the easiest thing you can do is use what you need, and that's to push. But we're watching Quantic go again. They're like, okay, if Na'Vi doesn't want to hold us off, the fortification is down, Miguel still has 2 levels on Edict, why not push? The tower's already down to half-life. Sure, Na'Vi take the bottom lane, and it's Arsat who gets the last hit for that one. Angel will try and hold it, but this tier 2 tower is gone on top. Mania pops into Sandstorm, and that's just to kill off the creep wave. Ryze creates more, and they're looking at a tier 2, tier 2 trade. Arsat puts liquid fire on the tower, slows down the attack. They're going to look for a kill here on Angel, while top lane, they keep going. Quantic are going to go for a tier 3 tower. Link is forced back from the middle lane. Dendi is going a long way down. He has Windrun, so he doesn't give 2 hoots. But Quantic going to keep on pushing. And Na'Vi will do the same. This is the standoff. Quantic go in. Tier 3 tower. Edict is now off cooldown. They have a faster push than Na'Vi does. Line of Heaven cannot get in close. The spires are brought down. Mania makes sure of that. Teepa support is not coming back again.
Miguel's
taking way too much damage from the tower. Line of Heaven spiders. Not enough damage. And they instantly pop the salve on him. Get him back up again. But that's still a big push from Quantic. Tower's down half life. If they do another push like that at full life and
look
full
at the
mana,
graph.
You're not gonna stop it. What the hell?
Tower. It's an N. It's my signature. It's the big N at the end.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's the trolling Nielsen.
It's the capital N, man.
Look at him go
Quantic
top lane.
Really
look at
this.
Him go. They want to go for Light of Heaven. If they can land the Mania stun, they might get it as well because they've got a chain stun plus the sprout.
They can lock in Light of Heaven for a long time, and even if it goes invisible, the
now
Edict
the TP comes down. Arsat's forced out. Illusion. Space is given to Angel on the bottom lane, and the pushing pressure is now gone. And Link still farms up in middle lane.
Vos going really aggressive on Angel here, taking a lot of damage himself. He could be in over his head here.
Oh, man. He needs to go Invis, but he doesn't have it. He's not level 6 yet. He blinks in on Angel. Angel turns his back. Face him! You, my friend. Ryze TP's in.
That's so ballsy to go for that when there's a Prophet on the other side who could have just TP'd in there. Holy.
I don't think Enigma would have died. And now, Havoc! Fire Strike, they will get the revenge kill. Or no. Will they? He pops level 6 at the right time with that killer cost. He goes Infiz. Man, that's... Go!
Everything is going Na'Vi's way now.
Man,
and now pushing
so
mid
close.
Again. And the thing about this is Link in the middle is level 5, Dendi's level 7, and he has really owned Link in this mid lane. He's got twice his farm, just played super aggressive with that Windrunner, constantly harassed him back. And this tower is going to go Na'Vi's way as well. They're now 4 for nil, they're ahead by 1 tower, and this is not looking like a good situation for Quantic at the moment.
No, it's looking bad, and they can't stop this push from Na'Vi. Ryze is not level 6 yet. He's been part of these tri-lanes. It's like, what are we going to do? I'll have a dual air. I didn't get to go inside the jungle. And Na'Vi push on a tier 2 tower. They did... Actually, is that Alpha... Yeah, that Alpha Wolf is timed out from Enchantress. I was wondering where all their excess damage was gone. And it's going to be a tier 1 for a tier 2, tier 2 trade. Oh, TP. A forced in too far. Angel. Cast a black hole! The Jackal! Huge on Link! Link would fire the big breath! It is enough! Windrunner gets the kill with a power shot flying through. Havoc manages to live even though he's stunned. Miguel lands off the stun, but he's losing a lot of life right now. AM will finish the job, killing off. And
no
another
way.
Jackal! Dandy, you are a genius! Three go down. Poppy is caught in Sprout. Ryze, he's one last right click. He gets it. Dandy now in the body block. Hassan, there goes the breath. Liquid fire. Link is trying to stay there. Ryze wants to pop off something, but he can't do anything.
Is there anything Dendi can't do?
I do not know. Maybe have 5 women at one time.
Unreal.
That might be impossible, but with play like that, as Dota 2 gets bigger, I'm pretty sure we can buy it.
And Light of Heaven takes the top tower.
Man.
Holy. That was... I'm a little dumbfounded now, man.
The Shackles. Two of the best Shackles you could have asked for. Stopping the Enigma Black Hole, catching the retreating heroes. Huge hits.
I love the call from the chat from Mithgrindir. 2 legs on the Shackles from Dendi there. Yeah, that's absolutely... That's really... That was insane, and it looks so good for Quantic with that black hole from Angel. I thought this is going to be really good. They've got Rikimaru very low.
The follow-up missing. Mania came in, but he didn't have that epicenter. He now has it. Prophet has no ultimate. These two big things. That is a lot of damage to be done to Na'Vi. They wouldn't have had the fight they did if those two abilities were up.
The question is if it's too late now, because Na'Vi are ahead by 7,500 gold.
Light of Heaven's gonna be really careful. Conversions are coming up. Angel is here. He's gonna spot off Arsar, landing off the stun. And the rest of Quantic will probably rally to this, but I don't think they know who's here. Puppy is here. Arsar is here. Dendi is on the run, and he has a mech and face boots at just under 10 minutes. What is this guy's goal per minute? 489.
That's huge in early game. That's really insane.
Mani has 316. He is the highest for Quantic, and now we see the pause out from Quantic. Have a powwow, have a think, and go, what the hell am I supposed to do? This is not a Mexican standoff, this is a breakfast of some sorts.
Yeah, this is gonna be really, really hard for Quantic, but as you said it, man, they're getting the level 6s now. Sand King with the Epicenter, Prophet with the level 6, but at the same time, the mech is up. The timing for Na'Vi is perfect because that's the counter they really need at this point.
Prophet's ultimate damage is completely countered
by negated. That. It's not going to negate Epicenter and Prophet's ultimate.
No,
but
that's hard.
that would require a pipe as well, but it's still... Quantic need to land it really well now. Miggle is also in a situation he's not really used to being in. He's level 5 at 10 minutes.
I think people just had the Broodmother disconnection problem.
We had
4 people just disconnect. I think it was
that
the because it's a known bug in the world of Dota 2 right now that if every single point of a web
takes off
a tree, did he?
He didn't place it right now.
And
so in that
case, maybe it wasn't. I don't know what happened then.
But it's a weird bug. I think it is fixed though. I'm not sure.
Maybe.
But still,
it was fixed in the test version. I think it's done in the real version.
Mm-hmm.
I say real version. I still don't see the point of the test version. But that's a conversation for another time.
Oh, Puppy's going to go in from behind with the creeps. Ooh. What a pause is that?
Arsart's out. I do not know what's going on right now.
And Light of Heaven.
And Light of Heaven. So, yeah, there's some form of trouble in the... Oh, hello. Even I'm timing out.
Toby disconnects.
Awesome. Great. Let's just...
I'm a baller. I'm going to stay in this game.
Well, that's good. That's great for you, man. I hope you have a great time with that. I'm going to come back inside the game so everyone else can watch it. It's great if you stay in there. We have a way of capturing your screen. Not... damn it, they're in. Don't you start again. Hey, I'm reconnected, but I'm not in. Damn it to hell.
You'll be in a moment. Yeah. There we go.
Awesome. So, random drops. Random drops. Hopefully, yeah, let's wait a few minutes. It gives us time to talk about this. Okay, let's think about Quantic.
Yeah.
How do they deal with this? They still have an insane amount of team fight potential through the Enigma black hole, through Mania's epicenter, even if there is the pipe. If they catch that black hole and they catch Windrunner in there, if they catch Windrunner in there, the mech doesn't come off. They don't get that counter. If they find Enchantress, they don't have her heal. Light of Heaven does little to no damage right now. He just stands there and tanks. They won't care about him. They still have a lot. Pull him in, land those stuns. They got good damage to come from Miguel. Two levels on Edict, two levels on Split Earth. Mania already has the three on Burrow, so that's a decent amount of initial damage. The only thing they're going to be worried about is all these creeps off Puppy.
And the Shackle shot.
And the Shackle. And Ricky, who will possibly pop off a smoke. But then again, how's Link looking? He's got Vanguard. He's got Vanguard 10 minutes into this game. Doesn't have anything else, but he has Vanguard. So that lets him live for the moment. The call for go, so we just don't jump a camera back up to the top. But Quantic, I don't think, will be too concerned about this. The Shackle. Oh, look, trees respawn. Lol.
Well, Puppy's going to go really aggressive with these creeps. He's just going to throw them away, effectively.
Yeah. But they've got time life. They've done their purpose. Oh Miguel!
Wow,
trouble! Huge damage. Proper pops off the oven. Dandy popping the power shot. Only just misses there on Angel. Blink in from Havorst. He was looking for Ryze. He's already popped off the smoke, but he can go back in there if he wants to have Mania. And now three heroes up here for Quantic. Looking to hold off, but I do think they can.
No. They can't do anything.
They have no black hole.
They have to let this go.
10 seconds.
11 minutes.
10 seconds. On black hole. 10 seconds. Was what they needed.
11 minutes was all Na'Vi needed to take 6 towers.
Dire's top tower has fallen.
That is insane.
The funny thing is, I was calling tier 1, tier 2 towers down by 10 minutes. I was a little bit off.
That was pretty close. But I mean, the trade-off the Quantic has got is probably the best they could have wished for with this. I mean, they've got 3 towers in trade. Of course, they wouldn't have expected to lose their towers at this point. You'd never draft to lose towers like this, but the trade-off they've got is actually not half bad. And if they get one or two good fights, they could make their way back in this. The challenge is to get AM farm.
Yeah.
And if the map blackens out and Na'Vi really start counter-warding and taking over the forest of the Dire, I am not sure I see Quantic's way back in this. It's going to be so hard for them to find farm on the map. You see Ryze now farming the Radiant Woods. He's not safe out here.
No. And they need to get out too. Na'Vi realize what's going on. They realize there is a push coming from Link on the bottom. He has a TP scroll, but Link can just blink and TP instantly. And now Prophet, best sprout of his life. best TP of his life. It's like, hey, I'm going to get this creep camp. What light of heaven? What? Ooh. Oh, look at the balls. The balls from Link. Puppy's just there, prancing around, and Link is just like, have you seen the size of my two blades?
Yeah, they're pretty big. He's getting some farm up. He's got a Vanguard in 12.
And then he eats through the tree the second Puppy leaves. It would have shown his position. He'll go, hey, there should be a creep camp here. Oh, hang on. Something is not right about the situation. Dendi, Shackle, doesn't lash Miguel. He wasn't close enough to the tree. Then now Miguel turns around, wants to land off that stunt, and he's not going to do it. Pow! Oh, Dendi.
That DD rune coming very much in handy. They're doing so much damage to Miguel and getting.
And now he's going to go Mania. He's going to look for the Shackle again. And Shackle doesn't lash, but does bring him out of Sandstorm.
I really think Mania was really thinking about that one. He totally wanted to go, but he saw the backup.
You were thinking about Burrow Epi, weren't you?
Yeah, and especially he had the backup of Angel with the Malachi.
Angel's almost got himself a full mech. So they've almost got one themselves. It's taking a little bit longer, of course.
It's not half bad for the game he's had, actually. Doing quite good on that farm.
Dendi. Diddy Rune's trying to slow this down. Burrow Strike. Just trying to kill off this creep. Shackle tries to land up as well. They're just looking for an easy opening in. But with Link now back towards the front lines, And he's going to go for that Yasha, already buying the Boots of Elveskin. He's looking for anything he can get right now. Unless he just goes treads.
Yeah, and
that could be possible as well.
At the same time, we talked about how Light of Heaven was being really held down to begin with.
Mm-hmm.
He now has the same farm. He has better farm than Link, who was the one free, or well, not free farming, but who was set up to farm in mid.
Oh, bottom.
Lost doing. Look at those slices. Take about a tenth of Link's health per slice, and he has a Vanguard.
Hmm.
That hurts.
Only for the back. Yeah, okay, they're getting... No, really? He's got a blink. He turns around. He just wants to burn the Mana of Ricky. What a Jackal! To the creep!
Is there anything he can't do?
Hey, dude, you keep asking that, and you keep getting your answer. The answer is no. In this case, no means yes for everything Denny wants to do. Now trouble for Angel. He's locked inside a troll trap. Arsart misses the stun right now. Angel's able to get himself out, but not too far out. Jakira gets the last hit in, even though Puppy did a lot of damage, and now SA wants to go bottom. He's like, somebody come and help me. I got two people to kill.
Yeah, Meagle is really weak at this point. He's got a HP pool of 700, and Havos can very quickly make work of him. He looks like he's looking for Ryze at the moment, but nobody's nearby to help. And it's just this is so dangerous for Quantic. They can't really get out of the base. Because Ricky Maru could be anywhere. Brood could be anywhere in the webs. And at the same time, there's no idea what supports are.
On the two on the top, but Enchantress is here. And just right-clicking Mania down. Mania is gone. Denny says hi to you, man. And then the AM ulti pops. Popping up Puppy. He went just a little bit too far, taking up the tower. And they kill off that ward.
And Divorce is already pushing and farming bottom lane again. Pause coming out from Miggle.
Yeah, there was a little bit of lag coming out from Angel. And Enigma will disconnect. So I think they want to go for a reboot. Wow, this is a really hard position for Quantic. But there's just so many openings which are coming out of nowhere. Well, I say nowhere, they're coming out of Shackles.
Yeah.
So many of them are coming out of Shackles.
It's like the funny thing about that setup in the bottom, I'm not sure if you realize, but if you look at the map over here on your screen, like, that's the wrong place.
Yeah, where are you looking at?
Up here, the dire.
Oh, you're actually looking at the tier 2 tower in the bottom lane.
Yeah, there.
Yeah.
Right beneath that big rock, here, that's where Dendi was standing, there. He was standing in there to get a diagonal shackle shot on AM from in there, but then he doesn't have the range. He wanted to land a creep and then have AM in the diagonal. I was like, that's going to be a perfect shackle shot. The funny thing is, if he would have landed that, they wouldn't have killed AM because the damage would have been insufficient. But AM just keeps fighting with Havost. And then there's one creep left that Dendi can land the shackle on. He gets it in the biggest angle possible before it's a miss. And it's like...
He can work
it. He also got a little lucky there, you got to say, because that shackle shot, if he would have landed the initial one, I don't think they had the kill. They would have just forced him back.
Mm-hmm.
But... Shackle shot is just, this is like, you remember when Puppy said that, right? That it's the best ability in the game.
It's the reason why he loves picking him whenever he has the opportunity.
And Dendi is just so
And can you agree 100% saying that Windrunner and Enchantress were a good first two picks?
It was
instead
really
of the anti-mage.
And the thing about the AM, and it's what really crippled Na'Vi in the first two games, and I think they've realized it as well. They gave away profit, and they did something you would normally never do. They gave profit together with AM.
Mm.
But they did it as it was a totally deliberate choice. They were like, okay, what can we get in a trade? We can get Enchantress and Windrunner and Brood for the trade-off. And that's what they did. And so far, so good, I guess you have to say.
Well, so we have to have ourselves a quick load coming out because we're having some issues with Angel being able to reconnect back inside the game. So we will have to have a reload. Luckily, from 0 minutes, Ryze is asking for a complete restart on it. Yeah, 15 minutes should be available. And then Holy Master will have to check it before we can have it. Okay. So let's go. Seems crashed. We'll go 15. So on the bright side, we get to jump out and you get to see our lovely faces for just a couple of moments. So we can't rejoin. So Holy Master, remake our game number 5. Of course, luckily, we have the remake feature. If we didn't send... I would be crying.
I think Na'Vi would as well if they wouldn't be rewarded the win with the current situation they're in. They would
what?
Be
just because it's,
really
it's 13-3 with a... I didn't want to look at this. I'm going to show you guys at home. 10K. 10.
At 15 minutes.
10.
This is really... this is brutal, man. It's...
Yeah. So we're gonna have a check. Holy Master's gonna let us know because he's gonna disconnect from the game to check the load. But to do that, he's gonna have to completely abandon the game, which means he is out.
Yeah.
So, yeah. This is going to be something we want, and it's a good thing for him to double check this. Yeah. We do not want to have a moment where we disconnect out and say, when's our last save? 5 minutes in. Whoa. that's not what we want to go back to. I think Na'Vi would highly debate that and just say, just give us 10 kills. then we'll play on. Just give us 10 kills. That'll be fine.
I doubt they would be. Nah, probably not.
It'll work. What are you talking about? It's a great plan. Because you look at the eyes right now, Light of Heaven. He's even getting himself an Orchid of Malevolence. We're getting a Broodmother with an Orchid. We've got a Yasha on Havorst at 15 minutes with Treads. What else have we got? Arsart's even walking around with a ring. He's looking to complete up the pipe. And once that's up, nothing's going to stop the Na'vi push in. Absolutely nothing can stop the Na'vi push in.
That's my concern for Quantic as well. I think when the pipe is up, they're in deep trouble.
Yeah.
As but if they aren't now, but when that happens... It's just almost impossible, because what Na'vi can do at that point is they can go in, they can start soft pushing with the THD and the Broodlings and whatever they feel like, Dendi on a long range, and then whenever they feel like something's about to come up, they can pop the pipe and retreat, because Quantic can't fight. So they have like that window of the duration of the pipe to just back out in.
Okay, Holy Master got the save game, so we're going to disconnect ourselves back out again, and it should already be remade. I am hoping. I do not see it yet, but I'm sure. I have all the confidence in Holy Man. I have all the confidence in Holy.
The Holy Man Master.
The Holy Man Master. What? Really? The Dennis Holy of Marcus Schumacher's?
Holy Marcus.
Rain's the only one in this game. I don't think that's the correct game.
I can't see it at the moment.
Oh, no, there we go. Now everybody connects in here. Everyone's like, hey, they're all in here. This is the best place to go.
Is this the real game?
Is this actually the remake?
No, it's not. Get them out.
Yeah, okay. Not the real remake. Well done. Well done. Holy Master is in a different game. Yep. So, let's get out of there. You might want to go back in there and tell them that. I realized that when I left, I didn't tell them that. Wrong game. Wrong game, guys.
And now they're going to come in.
I blame Rain. He's the one that created the lobby. So, it's all his fault. But Rain, of course, is our news guy. He's been doing a summary as we've been going. So if anyone did miss the games, the VODs will all be available over at joindota.com. You can check them out on our VODs tab. They're, of course, hooked into our own 3D TV library. You'll also be able to see them over on YouTube. That is youtube.com/joindota. They will be available there as well, including our two-hour talk we had beforehand, just basically discussing everything the defense. We went a little bit sidetracked on a couple of important topics for Dota 2 as well. But I'm pretty sure you guys would find that very, very entertaining. But everyone's coming back inside the game. The load should work properly.
Fingers crossed for that.
Fingers crossed. Okay, well done. Well done, man. We'll take that screenshot for you. Well done to Rain. All right, guys, ready to go. Well done to Light of Heaven. It's online, don't it, guys? You got to remember online. It's not the most stablest of the world. But then again, LAN events are never really 100% stable as well.
No, there can always be something happening regardless of where it is.
Because as far as everything that could have gone wrong tonight, we've had our share of problems, but everything works because we have reconnect features. Because we have a lovely guy over at Valve called Zoid, who love you, man, who takes care of everything. Game's going to restart up.
We're going out.
We'll see where we re-come back in. 25 minutes it was?
15.
Wow, how did I just lose 10 minutes of my life? let's jump ourselves inside the game. Everybody connects in, spectators finish connecting in, and the players, of course, we do see our captain's mode for just a moment, but then it'll automatically come in and pause the game. It will automatically come in and pause the game. The load did not work correctly. we are going to be back here in a couple of moments again. Well done to Holy Master. He says he has the save game, but it didn't work.
Oh man, if we can't recover it now.
No.
I'm jinxing it.
Do not talk like that.
I say something like that, it's not going to be true.
Throw a black cat over your shoulder or something. I don't know what you do when that happens. Is it the black cat?
It's close enough.
It's a mamba. Actually, no, it's a...
Black mamba? It's
I got an Impreta and I've got a...
A black mamba.
I always call it a Lycus, but I know it's Lycius or whatever the frickin'.
Oh, Lachesis.
Razer names are so weird for their products.
I wonder what that actually comes from.
Mm-hmm.
Lachesis.
Okay, so Holy Master should be remaking the game again. Yeah. Lucina just pops up and says, they left, man. Why did they leave? I don't know what's going on, man. Why did they leave? Yeah, we have the 15-minute save. Tell the players to leave. Well done, Holy Master. However, I don't know if you can see the game, man. At this point, you're watching IRC, which doesn't really help.
I can see the game.
You can? What? Mm-hmm. Hey, there we go. It came
so
up.
So can you.
Awesome. Great.
Why do I have to enter the password again and you don't?
Because I'm just so totally boss. Because I type in the password and search for the server.
Yeah, I did that lobby beforehand as well, but apparently it forgot.
Mm. It happens when you disconnect. Every now and then. All right, but we're back inside the game now, so all the players will reconnect. We are still stuck at 2-2, but Na'Vi look like they're in the position to remain undefeated in online competition. They've been defeated in LAN competition, where they are undefeated in online competition. How like, devastating would it be for all of Ukraine? Like, it'll be a day where you could only wear black outside if Na'Vi lost.
Black Mamba.
Like, that's like us, man. We've been through that. Or like, see us. However you pronounce it. All right, everybody's in. All right, so it's good to see Holy Masters. Zoid is still up. Zoid is still up and helping out with this. I want to point out that Zoid, with his time zone, when this started off, it would have been about 3 a.m. in the morning.
No. He lives in America.
On the American time zone. Actually, yeah.
It's afternoon now.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow, time flies when you're having fun. Really? In Seattle.
But you're right, he shouldn't really have been awake.
Awake at 5 or 6 a.m. Yeah. in the morning, whatever yeah. it was. Yeah.
I don't know when it was.
The man doesn't sleep. The man is here for the greater good of Dota.
Well, you don't wake up before 12 in the noon if you have free choice.
Yeah, of course.
Definitely not. Hell, all right, anyway.
That's retarded, man.
Dire team ban.
Right. Not again.
He's doing it again. All right.
Oh, please tell me this isn't true. That would just be really
we don't want to see this happen. All right. We might actually split this bot up into two different pieces right now. So we're going to be back here in a moment, guys. Do not go anywhere. The final, what could be 10 minutes and what could be 30, could be coming up in just a moment. Stick around, guys.
I said good day, sir!